Yeah, and the latest measurement technique that we have available is defined in -8. It's the so-called IC stripline method. And remember, I told you a lot about the DEM cell and the GTEM cell, and the IC stripline is operating exactly on the same principle. Let's imagine a DEM cell and make the DEM cell smaller and smaller and smaller, and then somehow you will most probably end up with this IC stripline. Well, the basic idea was coming from a lot of discussions that we had when I was at Infineon, together with Mr. Körber from the Fachhochschule of Applied, or the University of Applied Sciences in Zwickau, where we thought about that we need to extend the frequency range. As I told you, the DEM cell, it's limited to 1 GHz, 2 GHz, maybe 3 GHz, depending on how the DEM cell is constructed. And yeah, we were discussing a lot of different solutions, and one solution was, oh, we can also shrink the DEM cell and then finally just place a piece of copper on top of the IC and then solder this piece of copper in a triangular way on the printed circuit board. And then we have a very small distance between the package of the IC to this copper plate, so this internal septum of this DEM cell is then used in the form of a copper plate that is placed on top of the IC package. And then we thought about that it would be beneficial to have a kind of test fixture where not the copper plate is placed on the printed circuit board, but this copper plate is fixed and the printed circuit board is placed on top of this copper plate. And then the final solution was coming out with this prototype, or this is currently a commercial available type. You can see this copper plate shaped as more or less the septum, connected here in a very well-defined 50-ohm system to an SMA connector here, and here on this side is also an SMA connector. You can see it here. One is terminated then by 50-ohm, and the other one is going to the 50-ohm input impedance of the EMI receiver. And then a printed circuit board, again, the standardized 10 × 10 cm printed circuit board with the IC on the test, is placed then in this test fixture. So here is the IC, and you are closing it, and then the IC is more or less facing in the direction of this small copper plate. So this is the side view. We have the IC, and when the IC is operating, as we said, it's generating a kind of capacitive coupling from the metal structures inside of the IC to the metal of this copper plate. So there is capacitive coupling, and there is also magnetic coupling because there is a current flowing through the IC. So for example, supply current goes in here, flows into the microchip and goes out here, so we have a current flowing here. Then there is a magnetic field coming out of this small loop area, and this magnetic field is also then somehow circling around this metal plate, introducing a current, which is then finally measured as a voltage drop at the EMI receiver. So again, we can measure the H field and the E field contribution of an IC, but again, in a standardized, well-defined mechanical structure. And the big advantage is that the frequency range, depending on the design and how this is constructed, is a little bit higher, goes up to 3 GHz, 4 GHz, 5 GHz, depending on the structure. So we can increase the frequency range. And as the distance from the IC to the septum, to this metal plate, is not that big anymore, we can also increase the resolution or the accuracy of the measurement a little bit.